The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Very well, welcome to Mass this morning as we celebrate the great feast of All Saints, giving thanks for those who brought us to the faith, deepened it and inspired us and the whole Church over the centuries. And we include today, as we ask for the prayers of the saints, those who were martyred in the Basilica in Nice this week, remembering that people still die for their faith. And you will, I'm sure, have seen last night's news about a further lockdown, so it's all the more reason to rejoice in being together this morning, as very sadly this will be the only day of public worship, or the only Sunday of public worship this month. And we will still, however, be continuing with our Mass tomorrow night for All Souls, I'm glad to say, particularly after all the hard work that Jack Choir and the Invicta Ensemble have been putting into preparing for that. That's at 7 o'clock. If you haven't given your names to save a place, then please speak to one of the wardens, or indeed to add the name or names of any loved ones for whom you'd like to pray. And our last public worship before the lockdown will be the Wednesday morning Mass this week, before we return in December. Since we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, looking to Jesus in penitence and faith. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all creation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your faithful servants bless your name and speak of the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say together the words of that great hymn of praise, the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship, in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Grant us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those inexpressible joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please sit for our readings.
The first reading comes from the book of Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne, and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honour and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white? And These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the centre of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. This is the word of the Lord. The Psalm 34. The response to the Psalm is, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever be in my mouth. Fear the Lord, all you who his holy ones, for those who fear him lack nothing. Lions may lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever be in my mouth.
The second reading comes from the first letter of John. See what
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and told them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
Unfortunately for the Archbishop, he got summoned to Idi Amin's house. John's. If Paul was writing to St. John's, he would have addressed us as all the saints at St. John's Church. In the Gospel of St. Matthew, Jesus is teaching the first disciples and the multitude of crowds who have gathered and followed him to the mountain. From chapter 4, we know that Simon and his brother Andrew, James and his John, the sons of Zebedee, have abandoned their fishing nets and followed Jesus. This is Jesus' first teaching of disciples who would go out into the world to proclaim the kingdom of God. There are 8 criteria for the blessings that have been mentioned in the reading, which we had to read out. The poor in spirit, those who mourn, the meek, the hungry, and thirst for righteousness, the merciful, the pure in heart, and the peacemakers. Being poor in spirit means we humble ourselves and trust in God totally. We do not put ourselves first before others. We treat people with respect, regardless of their social or economic standing, their race, or their gender. The Feast of All Saints reminds us to think of who we are and what we are called for in our daily life. We are the ambassadors of peace in the world. God wants us to be bearers of peace, starting within our family at St. John's Church, at home, at work, and in our daily encounters with others. Recently, we've heard about the murders in churches in France. Yesterday, there was one of our Greek Orthodox priests that was murdered as he was closing the church. But we, the people, the saints at St. John's Church, we are the bearers of peace into the world we live in. In the reading from Revelations, it says, "After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands, the meek, the merciful, and the peacemakers, the ones who meet the criteria for the 8 blessings that were mentioned by Jesus at the mountain. The deliverance God gives us is not an escape, but a conquest. We pray for endurance and ability to remain upright and steadfast and come out of this COVID situation victorious. Amen.
We stand to affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was laid down. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. United in the company of all the faithful, and looking for the coming of the kingdom, let us offer our prayers to God, the source of all life and holiness. Merciful Lord, strengthen all Christian people by your Holy Spirit, that we may live as a royal priesthood and a holy nation, to the praise of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lord, in your mercy. Bless Christopher, our bishop, and all ministers of your church, that by faithful proclamation of your word, we may be built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Empower us by the gift of your holy and life-giving Spirit, that we may be transformed into the likeness of Christ, from glory to glory. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Give to the world and its peoples the peace that comes from above. They may find Christ's way of freedom and life. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Hold in your embrace all who witness to your love in the service of the poor and needy, all who minister to the sick and dying, and all who bring light to those in darkness. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Touch and heal all those whose lives are scarred by sin or disfigured by pain, but raised from death to life in Christ, their sorrow may be turned to eternal joy. We pray particularly this day for Jane and her partner Gillian, as she faces her terminal cancer, for Martin as he begins chemotherapy, and for Ava as she supports him, for Josephine, for Barbara, for Wayne, Patricia, Dinesh, his family, including his sister Shamila, for Harrison, Linda, Cliff, and his family as they watch with him, his partner J. Jan and his children Wendy and Father Martin, for Sora and for her family, and for Samantha. Lord, in your mercy. Remember in your mercy all those gone before us, who have been well pleasing to you from eternity. And we pray for particularly those martyred in Nice this week. Preserve in your faith your servants on earth. Guide us to your kingdom and grant us your peace at all times. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Hasten the day when many will come from east and west, from north and south, and sit at the table in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. We give you thanks for the whole company of your saints in glory, with whom in fellowship we join our prayers and praises. By your grace, may we, like them, be made perfect in your love. Blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honour and power, be to our God forever and ever. Amen. Please stand for the peace. We are fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, through Christ our Lord, who came and preached peace to those who were far off and those who were near. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Whether we're at home with others or in church today, from our places, let us offer one another a sign of that peace.
Thank you.
up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we give you thanks, most gracious God, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, and glorified in the assembly of your saints. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you. The white-robed army of martyrs praise you. We, your holy church, acclaim you. In communion with angels and archangels, and with all who served you on earth, and worship you now in heaven, we raise our voice to proclaim your glory, forever praising you.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Mother of the Lord, St. John the Baptist, St. Mark, St. Luke, St. Barnabas, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. With saints and martyrs through the ages, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God,
You take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. please stand. Lord of heaven, in this Eucharist you have brought us near to an innumerable company of angels, and to the spirits of the saints made perfect. As in this food of our earthly pilgrimage we have shared their fellowship, so may we come to share their joy in heaven, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies, to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit, to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Please be seated. Have we had any birthdays this week? Any birthdays? No birthdays. Unless anyone has at home. I can't see any messages flashing up. Nope, no birthdays. Notices, you'll no doubt all be slightly curious as to what we're going to be doing over the next month. As I said at the start of Mass, we are still keeping All Souls as planned, with Forre's Requiem being sung, so tomorrow night at 7, that should be a really special Mass as we pray for all of those who've died. And obviously there are many we'll be praying for this year who've died of the coronavirus, as well as all of those whom we have loved in times gone past but see no longer. And then Wednesday morning's Mass will also be as normal. But after that, the services will continue as normal, but they'll simply be behind closed doors and streamed online. So please find our Facebook page if you're not already familiar with it, or our YouTube channel. We are allowed to open for private prayer, which we'll be doing as well this time round, and the church will be open for private prayer. At least this is what Sonia and I just discussed this morning, because obviously it's rather late notice. We're hoping to open between 11:30 and 12:30 on Sunday morning. So after the parish mass, the church will be open for private prayer, as it will on Wednesdays between 8:30 and 9:30. So Sunday mornings 11:30 to 12:30, and Wednesday mornings 8:30 to 9:30. So please do come and make use of the church for private prayer, and to keep us alive with your prayers as the saints of God, as Alice referred to in her sermon earlier. Also an idea that I have following what some other churches are doing. I thought it might be worth trying having coffee on Zoom, so online coffee on Sundays at 12:30. So we'll give that a go. And if you'd like to join us for that, get a cup of coffee in hand, email me for the link, and then we'll just have half an hour where we can chat online to keep our community together. If you have any other ideas, please don't hesitate to get in touch with me or one of the wardens as well, as to how we can keep the church's life going and in full spirit over the next month. And on that note as well, we're lacking a few St. John's at 4 leaders. We don't have anyone for the 4th Sunday or the 5th Sunday when that happens at the moment. So if anyone would like to volunteer to lead our St. John's at 4 services, or online worship will be all the more important over the next month, then please get in touch with one of the wardens. And I'll start phoning again for those of you that aren't online. And also, if anyone needs any shopping or medication, then please do get in touch with either me or one of the wardens as well. And we'll do what we can to keep us together for the next month before we start our public worship again in December. And now please stand for the blessing. The Lord be with you. May God, who kindled the fire of his love in the hearts of the saints, pour upon you the riches of his grace. Amen. May he give you joy in their fellowship and a share in their praises. Amen. May he strengthen you to follow them in the way of holiness and to come to the full radiance of glory. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Following God's saints in the ways of holiness and truth, go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.